Welcome back, Legionnaires, and we're here with another bit of isolation entertainment as we are doing a Thrones of Britannia siege today. We have a 2v2 on large armies. It is the Hebrides and Wessex versus Gwynedd, which is basically Wales, and Mercia attacking. And we have an epic sally in this battle. It's very bizarre, I guess, for Thrones. I mean, most people stay inside the walls when they're playing as on Thrones. But here we go, straight away. It looks like Wessex is going to send up some mailed horsemen, and we've got an assortment of infantry going out the gates as well. But yeah, I mean, when you've got the ability just to form shield wall, why wouldn't you just do that? But here we go, it looks like Mercy's going to be sending up some mailed horsemen, and they're going to be fighting the mailed horsemen here. So this was sent in by one of the subs to the channel, also a member of the Discord. So if you want to get involved and send in your replays that may then feature on the channel, do join the Discord down below. The link is in the description. And also, if you want to just get involved in any battles that with me and other subs, then also just join the Discord. But here we go. Look at the fire coming in. I mean, that's horrific. I mean, these horsemen are actually probably going to get, like, destroyed. I mean, are they losing? They are. Losing decisively because of that. I mean, look at all these Eastman hunters here. So, yeah, these guys have, like, a weird name with their S. I'm not even going to... It's like Sodrea or something like that. But they're basically just the Hebrides. Yeah, they're already flanking around. They're going to just take out Mercy over here. On the other side, it does look like Wales is not in. I was about to say is in, but there's just a lot of skirmishing going on. He's got his longbows ready. Look at that, like, trajectory that they're doing. That's, like, very impressive. I mean, they're focusing down these guys, these Eastman spearmen. I mean, not a bad unit to just use to get, like, soak up all the ammo. But I would definitely be just, like, put them in shield wall. You've got a better chance over here. We've got a flanking force over here of the cavalry. It's trying to get out and do its thing. We've got plenty of infantry now out here. Look at this line of infantry. Like, the Hebrides is fully committing to this. Like, there is no... They've got sent so many troops out now. It's not a bad idea, but, like, if this doesn't go well, they've lost the siege very, very quickly. I mean, a lot of mailed Danes over here, they're probably going to do okay in combat. I mean, they're definitely going to prefer to fight, like, in the open. Like, look at that. Great Axe is already breaking. Not a good sign. We've got more Great Axes here losing. Hebrides is really, well, committing a lot of troops, basically, put it like that. And he is also, like, breaking everything back here. He's got cavalry back here. He's going to break all these feared archers. This is, it's paying off in a certain way. He's certainly getting, like, taking out a lot of key units for Mercia, but, I mean, okay, we've got Huskarls here, I presume. Yeah, Royal Huskarls. This is, I thought this might be the general, but it's not. He's, like, killing a lot of, like, major units, like the archers, but he's losing a lot of infantry for no reason. I mean, Wessex is also over here supporting, which is good for him, because Wessex has definitely got the more quality troops. Got more units breaking. I presume it's on the far side against Wales. I mean, look at this bunching here. If they can shoot this down with arrows, this is going to be huge. Got more men over here. Royal Thanes, they're winning. They've stopped Mercia in his tracks and just, like, trying to assault the walls, which, I mean, is fair enough. Mercia probably could do okay in a pitched battle. I mean, this is what it's become. I mean, this is kind of epic to watch. Just everyone fighting outside the walls. But it's, like, almost like a 1.5 versus 1. Like, Wessex is over here supporting. Wessex just needs to, like, send his troops through here and around, and it'll be fine. Like, I'll just get the HUD up. Yeah, if he sends his troops through here, through the rams, because I'm pretty sure units can just walk through the rams like they're non-existent, he can then just surround some of these big blobs. Because Mercy's basically got all of his troops engaged. Lots of archers here, and we've got an artillery piece of the Hebrides. I'm surprised they have this sort of equipment in the small islands of Scotland, but apparently so. I think the horseman for the Hebrides is also gone. I'm not sure. Yeah, can't see it. Does look like it's all gone. They've freed up some troops over Mercia. I mean, thing is, though, he's not got many places to actually put them in. They're also now getting focused on his Royal Huskars. A really good unit to take out. They've got lots of attack, melee attack, and they've also got they've got very little melee defense. We've got units breaking here. Spearguard breaking mailed Thanes by the looks of it. That's good. I mean, they need to stay really close to the walls because then the archers can support them. Like here, this Royal Huskar unit needs to get forward. He's pushing forward. Look, that's very good to see here. We've got the Hebrides doing just that. Let's just go and check out on the other side. Let's go and check out what's happening with Wales. Wales is actually making a bit of headway. He's getting inside the walls. He's got a very small army to be facing, but he does have to take out 3 bridge points with Spearguard on. Are these all got Spearguard on? They do. Okay, so yeah, this is going to be tough to take out. I would not want to have to deal with that. We've got more units here, Eastman Spears. He's just like basically putting in the bare minimum. What we've got here, Thanes. Yeah, so I think Wales have an okay time, but he's got to just do as much damage quickly while Mercy just soaks up all this attack. He needs to get inside his Wales quickly. This is actually turning into a bit of a foot race. If Mercy can hold on long enough, then he can take on like 1.5 armies. Then Wales should really be able to take out the half army that there is defending his side. Because it basically is what it is. I think Wessex has got very little there, and Hebrides has also got very little. Wessex seems to have just brought a really elite army. It's got a lot of Royal Thanes, a lot of Royal Huskars. More over here. This is huge. They need to get around here. I don't know what's happening here. Is this a unit in combat? Oh, there is like a small unit of Royal Huskars here in combat. Look at these guys. They're so bloodied up. They've been focused down by arrows, though. They still are getting focused on. The archers need to just hold their fire and start finding a bigger target, because this is done. But this is a huge flank that they've got going on here. They've got archers going out now. They must have run out of ammo. That's a bit of a concern. But, I mean, what have they got? All the artillery dead as well? Okay, one's still alive. The crew's almost gone. But they've got a unit all the way out here. I mean, it's a small unit, but if you can start surrounding some of these units, that'll be huge. And they've got archers. Oh, no, these are great axes that are just breaking. This is a concern. Looks like they've got very few units over hill holding back a lot of men. So Mercia is making a bit of a headway on this side. But we now have some of the more elite troops of Wessex in here. We've got some Thanes holding the line. But just looking at all the archers, just all the arrows arcing over. This is huge. It'll be interesting to see how many kills these guys have got. Can we have a volley? Loose! Very nice. But yeah, I mean, look at it. This is a concern for Mercy. He's got a lot of troops now pinned up in this area. It's almost like a circle. Or certainly a crescent. And he's just getting focused on by archers. He's certainly shooting these units here. It's going to be huge. But yeah, Wessex is also now in here. I mean, he's got his Royal Huskars. They'll certainly be chopping through shields like they're just butter. We've got more troops over here. I mean, this is not good. I mean, Hebrides holding on? Okay, he's got 2 units, but this is a lot of troops. Also, this is not good, I mean, by the Mercian play. He literally has got so many units piled back here for no reason. They're not helping. Just flank around. He can... Siege Tower. But he can literally just flank around. Oh, he's doing it finally. Here we go. And he can just get into the back of the Hebrides and Wessex over here. Or he could surround this unit. These units. Then he could free up all of these to go and then surround. But here we go. He's going to send in troops. He's going to support over here, which is good to see. A bit of a concern, though, that is that Mercia is actually losing this fight. I mean, this one's doing okay. This one is wavering. There is a unit around here, actually. Great axes here. How is Wales doing? Wales is doing well. Wales is doing well. Wessex is basically going to fall back what's left of his troops by the looks of it behind these bridges. Not a bad idea. Oh, they've still got archers all the way back here. They've got artillery. Wow. Okay, so, I mean, Wales is going to have a tough time getting through this. But he's done quite well so far. I mean, Wales on the attack is very bold to start with. They're very much a more defensive-minded faction. Got their longbows. I mean, they've not got many great swords. They've got a lot of good spears. But I mean, he's got a lot of his army left. He's brought some dogs. He's brought some warhounds. They're pretty epic. They look awesome. But yeah, I mean, I'd say that he's going to have a tough time breaking through those bridges. And I mean, it could go either way over here. Mercia just has to break this here. And he just probably wins this because he can then surround all of these. And then this is just basic. This is what's left, really, of like the sally out force. Over here, we're doing okay. But, well, they're doing okay. I was not in this. I was not in this battle. I would not be doing this. Like, I'd prefer to stay behind my walls. They got guys on the... They've got troops still on the tower. Poor guys. Like, imagine being here and you're like, oh god, we got to get off here some point. Like, if they kill all these men, then we're stuck up here. But yeah, it's going fairly well. I mean, does look like... Oh, that's a nice kill there. Very nice. Push him over his headless corpse with your shield. Looks like archers coming out. Archers now probably being used to just hold men back. Oh, this is good. This unit here is going to break. That's three units that can free up. And they have won over here as well. These two units of Mercy are going to break. So that is a big concern. Mercy really needs to win this fight, and soon. He's also got a unit here of Royal Thanes. Needs to get them back in. Yeah, these guys over here, they're holding so long. They've held on. What is this unit? These are spear. Okay, these are spear guard, and they are Eastmen, mailed axemen. They're actually doing okay. But I mean, just flank these guys. I'm begging Mercy, flank these men. Over here, he's doing okay. Wessex is slowly pushing back these Thanes. I do like the kite shields. The kite shields are really, really good looking. I mean, I also like the round. I mean, both are just round and kite. You can't go wrong. I mean, this period is just great. I mean, having watched Last Kingdom and then seeing Assassin's Creed Valhalla come out really got me in the Viking mood. But I mean, this unit here of Royal Thanes needs to get a move on and start flanking. You could flank all these Mercians here and you could break them probably quite quickly. Got archers fighting out over here. Actually, these archers? No, we've got spears fighting archers, I think. Or spears fighting... No, berserkers. Okay. I thought this is where... Oh, the Eastman Hunters have just broken. Okay, so there was archers here, but they're gone. But the berserkers, how will they do? Yet to see them fight it out. I expect to fight to the death. You should probably win this. It does look over there. There's a lot of movement going on. I think Mercy has won, or... He's certainly getting units to flank around. But anyway, we'll stick with the berserkers. The poor screams of men dying there. I mean, yeah, look, there you go. Mercy has won this by the looks of it. Hebrides, I think, pulled back what units he had and they broke because of it. Wessex is now having to really take on much of the hard work. I mean, there is a few units over here. If Wessex can just send these guys... I mean, route these Mercians one more time and then just send, like, the troops in, you probably can surround what's left. But here we go. It's going to be the clash on the bridge. Just catch this. It looks like it's going to be some swords from Wales first against Speargard. Oh, and shield wall. And we've got dogs being released, I've just seen. I wanted to go and check out some other shield walls, but I mean, there are the dogs. You can't really see them. But they are in there. Biting at people's ankles. Oh, you can hear the shouts of the dogs, or the howls. There we go, there's a couple. Look at this guy, he's taking on three dogs. He's just poking them with his spear. But these Welsh swords, they're okay. I think they're called armoured swords, or, yeah, mailed swords. They're okay. But they're not the greatest. They're pretty average. I mean, these Tululu spear guard are very good. But again, they're a spear unit. You're not going to break through a choke point with the spears. He needs to get his archers up. He's got longbows. They're a very good unit. He's got all of them over here set up. I just find, go to this checkpoint over here, shoot these guys to death. I mean, look at that spear wall, though. That is... This game is amazing for spear walls. I'll never get sick of seeing the shield wall, sorry. It's not spear wall. The shield wall in the Thrones, it just always is amazing. And it's always great to see it, like, when it clashes. But here we go. But yeah, these are spear guard fighting against, well, more spear guard of Wales. And they won't break through, I don't think. They've got... Oh my gosh, that was a harrowing volley. And there's another shield wall ready for the mailed spears here. Just ready. We've got select fjord archers back here. But I mean, look at that. Let me just get another volley. Look at that. That is brutal. But we will come back to this because I imagine the sally out is basically done. Yeah, I'd say Mercy's done. He is... And they're going to fall back. Look at that. They're not even going to finish Mercy off. They're going to fall back inside their walls and they're going to defend. And I don't actually know if this catapult's fired yet. I don't think it has. But Mercy's basically finished. The Berserker's over here. I actually might break these spears. I don't know. And Earl Thanes. What have they got here? Some Eastman archers? Yeah. There you go. They broke those spears. Now it's just this unit... Which is actually winning. The Berserkers, yeah, losing. I guess because they're trying to attack that unit of spears. But here we go. The British battle is about to begin. And it looks like Wales is a... Well, it depends. Can Wales do enough damage to what's over here before the reinforcements can arrive? The reinforcements of this successful sally. I'd say it was successful now. I think that Wales has broken through. Actually, no, it's... Don't know what happened here. I don't know how he got through. But... A nice little tactic, I guess, by the Hebrides. Let this unit through, then he can surround it. But yeah, these poor guys now... The poor Welshmen here just getting absolutely annihilated, I'd put it as. Definitely the way I put it. Now they're just getting focused on. I wouldn't even bother shooting this unit. There's very little to shoot at. I'd start focusing down their longbows, wherever they are, over here. Also, this blob here. Oh, they've got longbows in here as well. This is not a good thing. They've run out of ammo. This. Oh, here we go. Artillery. Oh, my gosh. Can we have some fiery balls, please? But, I mean, look at this. This is ridiculous. This battle has everything. It's had sallies. It's got epic catapult shots. Oh, my gosh. Yep. Yeah. Wales is pulling out, or Gwynedd is pulling out everything. Not a bad idea. Or keep one unit in here to fight it out. So this choke point's not just like got nothing in it. But I mean, do not blob up like that. That is a... I thought that's a total war no-no. You just don't do it. Oh my gosh, they're all the way back here now. But yeah, this is a huge blob. One more volley, I would just hold your fire soon. Oh, that one wasn't so good. That one kind of missed. That was devastating. I wonder how many kills these guys got. Where are they? Over here. Are they going to fire again? No, it looks like they're going to hold their fire. I mean, that was pretty devastating. There's a lot of mangled bodies down there. Horses. Yeah, Wales just needs to... I don't know. Needs to either send more troops on these other choke points. You just focus them all down so that they've got as many troops... like committed, so they don't have reserves, like loads of reserves. Because like right now, this unit could be considered a reserve, because they're not going to attack here for some reason. And they've got, I mean, Wessex bringing over a lot of troops now. I don't even think they're like, I don't know what's happened here. Mercy is just like AFK or what? I'm not sure. But like they're going to pull everything out. They're just not even bothered to like defend against Mercy. I mean, he's got nothing left though. Like this is just. Look at the death and destruction outside these walls. It looks amazing, but, like, it's pretty goddamn horrifying. They've still got archers firing at a few, like, Mercy units that survived. I mean, we've got some Eastman Axemen over here. We've got another Mercy. There's just a few just dotted around. I don't know what's having a Mercy here. I guess he's just AFK. I would go AFK and just, like, you've just been double-teamed by a sally out, which you probably should be winning because you've got better infantry as an attacker. And he's just got destroyed, basically, put it like that. But here we go. Wales is carrying on the fight. It looks like he's... oh, his catapult's coming up. This is going to be huge. See, this is what he's got to do. He's got to get the catapult up, and he's got to start focusing down choke points. This is the choke point I'd be going for as well, with your catapult. And you just got to test them and say, well, are you going to stand in this choke point? Well, if you are, I'm going to kill you for it. And use the catapult to do it. I mean, or use the catapult now here, because this is three units. And, I mean, these are pretty good. I mean, there's Fjord archers in here, which isn't the... I mean, they're clearly out of ammo, but we've got mailed swords in here. We've got spear guard. I mean, the spear guard's actually getting pretty beaten up. It's on a 68 now. I mean, Wales has still got quite a lot of reserves. He's still got stuff by the gate. He's got lots of longbows back here. I don't know if these guys have ammo. I'm going to say no, because they've got their daggers out. I can hit dogs as well. Have they got more warhounds? No, they've got longbows. Oh, they do have dogs. Okay, so these dogs hit... What happened to these dogs? They bugged out. That is bizarre. Okay. Anyway. On we go. We just forget about those dogs bugging out. It looks like over here, the Royal Spearmen are having, again, no luck. They're just not going to break through. Shield wall, look at that. That is disgusting. Not sure how he formed the shield wall. Well, I thought this unit was in combat, but... I just seem to never have luck with, like, when you're trying to form up, like, the unit just doesn't want to form shield wall. It's just like, no. Like, if you're in combat, it'll just go, no, I'm alright. I'm just gonna pretend that you didn't order me to do that. Here we go. Longbow's coming up. This is going to be pretty nasty. I mean, it shouldn't be too bad because they are in shield wall, but they're definitely going to take some casualties here. And the artillery's getting ready. Like, if you can see that all the way back there. That is, that's not a good sign if you were as one of these guys down here. You'd be like, hoping for like whatever, well, for the gods, because these guys are Vikings, that they run out of ammo soon. Because I don't know if they have been firing any ammo, Wales, but if they haven't, well, they're in trouble. I wouldn't commit, I wouldn't send these guys in. These longbows got ammo, please tell me they do. No, they got their daggers out, I'd say they don't. Don't, why charge in? Why charge in? Wales has made a mistake there. He shouldn't have charged in. Just stand like where those spears are and then just let the catapult shoot. Where is the catapult going? It's going beyond this gate. Or this, not gate, this bridge. It really needs to turn this round. Like, I mean, these two units he's now just thrown away. Or three units he's thrown away. Two longbows. I guess all his longbows are out of ammo, but still. Like, just get this artillery ready and set up. I would just... Like, look at all the reserves they've got back here as well. This is pretty nasty. I mean, the balance power now has shifted quite a bit. It's now even on the numbers. What has happened to Mercia? I'm just going to keep looking and just hoping that Mercia's going to have done something. But he's got about four units left. I mean, it's actually well played by the defenders, which became attackers. They did quite a good job and they just routed... Mercia off the field. It was insane. But I mean, this artillery needs to start doing some stuff. I don't know what he's going to do with it. It looks set and ready and primed. He's got a lot of troops now coming forward here. This is a bit of a concern for the defenders. A lot of troops coming forward. They've not got much in this choke point, actually. It's a very thin line. I mean, there is a shield wall line as well, so... That's always good. I mean, it looks like he's got archers as well, though. That's the only other thing. But they are breaking Wales. I mean, it was only longbows. But this is a good target for the catapult if it's ready. Oh, and Wales is across. Wales is across. Okay, so maybe that's why he's saving his ammo. And they're pulling back over here. Wales has got across. He's not got much. It's actually pretty close, I'd say. Wales has still got quite a lot. He needs to... Why would they then just commit these troops? It just seems like a stupid idea. He could surround them. But I mean, he's going to get this spear guard out of here. His Hebrides is going to have to sacrifice these archers, which I presume are out of ammo. And Wales desperately needs to take out the spear unit. Catch it out before it can get back to the enemy lines. Looks like a general's going to be the first in. If I would be focusing this unit down now. You're late into the game. It's okay to start general sniping. But this Royal Huskarl unit, I'd definitely be starting to take out. I'd also probably, I don't know. Oh, he looks like the, I was about to say he could go down and attack. It looks like Wessex looked like he was debating about it, then decided not to. Have they run out of ammo? Oh, please tell me they haven't run out of ammo already on their catapult. They have, I think. That, oh no, this is not their catapult. Did they not bring their catapult all the way up from, they didn't, did they? It's here, and it's, I bet it still had ammo. That crew just left. No, that's not good. Hebrides, I mean, it was going to take forever to get here, but you could have definitely set it up to like here, and you could have definitely got a few shots. Burned through some ammo. I mean, look at this horde of Welshmen coming up. There's nothing scarier than a horde of Welshmen. Speaking from experience, no, I'm not. I don't think I've ever witnessed a horde of Welshmen. I think you'd have to see that at a rugby match, and that would be about it. And if you don't know what rugby is, if you're like an American, it's just a better version of American football. Just to, not to hurt anyone's feelings there. I mean, just it's no padding. They're fearless. No, I'm joking. American football's also very, very fun to watch. But I mean, it does look like Wales is going to be breaking through here. And he's just going to surround this unit, this spear guard unit. Poor guys, he couldn't get it back in time. Over here, this is... Okay, they routed this Royal Spearman unit. It went up on its own. That was a brave move. But I mean, the general now needs to get back. Hebrides general needs to get back. Oh, he's going to go in. Okay. I mean, he doesn't have much left, I guess. But I mean, it is an action unit, so it does need to kind of do the charge. But you could have charged from the safety of your defences quite happily. But we'll see how long he holds. I mean, I think he might break this spear unit. Yeah, he might actually break that spear unit. But, I mean, he actually has got a few units left. He's got great axes. I mean, over here, they're doing a big flank by the looks of it. I'd be careful about that. I'd certainly be supporting down here. I keep putting a couple of units into here. I mean, the spear guard's doing okay, but it needs more troops. This artillery is more my concern. It needs to start firing. But in fairness, if they can hold... I mean, they've got across this choke point has Wessex. I guess just everyone's leaving stuff at the back just to do nothing. The general over here for Wales is just chilling out. He's got his dogs here. He's got longbows back here. He's got some royal spears. He needs to send them forward just to stop Wessex from really flanking, because that's what's about to happen. If they can break through here, then they can just attack on both flanks this long column of Welshmen, which is... That's what it's becoming. Oh, okay. And Hebrides' general has fallen. That might affect the morale of what's left of Hebrides. I mean, which is a concern because they are holding the choke point here. So Wessex might want to send a unit in. How did these Welsh swords get across here? And I mean, they're just being left to just get shot by this watchtower. But I mean, they really need to actually charge in the back here. They could break this spear guard. Especially now the general's dead. And it seems like there's been just a bit of a lack of micro at the end of this battle. Like, people have just given up a bit. But, certainly attackers. Wales seems to just forgotten that he has an army. But there we go. A Pyrrhic victory. I think Wales just gave up in the end. It's a bit of a shame to end this battle on. But, yeah, he just seems to just thrown in the towel. But we'll end the replay and look at the end results. There wasn't much left I don't think Wales could have done. He was surrounded and pretty much finished. But, we'll quickly have a look at... the Hebrides first. So, I mean, he got 236 kills with his spears here. Are these spear guard? Yeah, I think they were spear guard. These are, oh, wow, he brought a lot of spear guard. He also got a lot of kills with his berserkers down here, 237. No surprise there, they are berserkers. His archers, I thought they were going to get more kills. They seem to like be decimating troops, but apparently not. His artillery might have actually run out of ammo because he got 120 kills with it. And his, he's got more berserkers down here getting 119. And he's got, what are these great axes? He's got 167 with, that's not bad either. Oh no, these are, the mailed axes, aren't they? They're the great axes there. But anyway, so well done to Sachex who sent this in, playing as the Hebrides. It was a good result in the end for him. And we'll quickly look at Cabo Thundernuts. What a name, I guess. And he was playing as Wessex. He got 259 kills here with his spears. He's got... What are this? He's got his mailed spearmen here, 104. That's not bad. He's got mailed swords here, 257. these are his Thanes, I'm pretty sure. He's got Royal Thanes here getting 137, not bad. What's he got here? He's got Axes getting 136. That's not bad. These are the Huskarls, aren't they? 160 here with his other Royal Huskarls. His Archers getting 84. I think it's the best one. His Archers did okay. His Cavalry of 88. That's not bad. And his Catapult getting 173 in that huge blob. That was an excellent target. Then we'll go on to Cluckety Chicken, who's playing as Mercy. He was had a rough time, to be honest. With a great sally out. I mean, his cavalry got overwhelmed. His artillery got 131 kills. That's pretty impressive. His axes here, his Huskarls getting 128, 132. His Thanes here getting 175. That's not a bad result for them. I mean, most of his swords did okay. Quite a few did get overwhelmed, though. His spears got overwhelmed. So yeah, unfortunate for him. And then quickly, the big Sniff, who played as Gwynd or Wales, his dogs getting 7 kills. That's a shame. I hope they'll get more kills. His longbows, unfortunately, he brought a lot of longbows. 94, the best one did. Look at all those longbows he brought. I mean, Wales does have good longbows. His spears not doing so great. They were on the assault. He brought a lot of spears, which is the problem going as Gwynd. He would have been better defending. Brought so many spears. I mean, the best one getting like 135 kills. Still isn't. This is okay, but could have done better with more swords, which he only brought 4 of, and he only got like 77 kills. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this battle and want to see more Thrones of Britannia action, please do leave a like, subscribe, and a comment to show your support. And if you want to join any battles, then please do join the Discord, which is in the description down below. And until next time, Legionnaires, I will see you guys later.